A very effective martial arts weapon in the hands of the police.
This is World News Tonight with Peter Jennings.
Our next report tonight is about a new weapon in the police arsenal, which is extremely effective. For one particular reason, it can be extremely painful. In Los Angeles, over the weekend, police used nunchucks, those devices that look like two nightsticks tied together, at a demonstration against abortion.
Kevin Orcutt, a relatively unknown policeman from Thornton, Colorado, is showing the officers of America what this odd oriental weapon can do for them.
We can take him right on down if we have to.
When a police officer gets a grip with his nunchucks, you go where he goes. It creates leverage officers just can't get with their hands. The San Diego Police Department was among the first to use Orcutt's nunchucks to arrest anti-abortion demonstrators. It hurts a lot, which is partly why it's so effective. The Orcutt Police Nunchuck, as it's called, is two sticks of high-impact plastic joined at one end by heavy nylon cord. Unlike the one used by Bruce Lee, made of wood and a chain, Orcutt's tool is designed for controlling a person, not killing him.
If I could provide an officer with a way to better restrain and control someone who's resisting him, violently even, it would reduce injuries, actually, because you wouldn't have to resort to hitting them.
The nunchucks are designed to be used in ways the old straight nightstick never could.
Down on the ground. Lay flat. Lay flat.
Only police departments can buy them. More than 50 of them have. And like here in Costa Mesa, California, they have to buy the training as well, part of which is that you only swing in self-defense. But police say the nunchucks are so good, sometimes the mystique of them does the job.
Most people, you know, watch TV and stuff, so they know what it is. And most of the time when they see it, they don't want to mess with it.
You don't want there to be really a fair fight between a criminal and a police officer. You want the officer to have the leading edge.
The nunchucks are supposed to cause pain without permanent damage, although some of the San Diego demonstrators said they hurt too much.
I tried to go limp, but the searing pain was so intense that I did walk with them.
But that's the idea. Nunchucks are now being tested by the Los Angeles police as an alternative to the painful holds police have been using. If they like it here, beat police all over America might end up swinging a strange stick. Brian Rooney, ABC News, Los Angeles.
And coming up next, the karate weapon that cops all over the country are adding to their arsenal. Officers are using nunchucks as weapons, often in place of a nightstick or a gun. And joining us now to show us how it works is a man who started the trend, Sergeant Kevin Orcutt of Thornton, Colorado. Good morning.
Good morning, Harry.
How did you come to use one of these things? Because it looks like a kind of a macho, here I am, Mr. Karate guy out in the street. It looks kind of menacing. How did you come to start using one?
Well, the idea came to me when I would see officers in the field having problems controlling people. And so my idea was, being involved in martial arts and police work, having had experience with the tool, the weapon, in the martial arts sense, was to try to blend the two and come up with some ways it could be used for police work effectively.
How many times have you used this thing in your own work?
Oh, probably at least a couple hundred.
Couple hundred
years.
Times.
Yeah, it's been on the street in my city for 8 years now.
Why is it better than a nightstick, for instance?
Well, it's flexible. It will actually wrap around an arm or a leg, anything that might attack me,
mm-hmm.
and I can control it with quite a bit of leverage.
As this thing is spreading around the country, there are complaints now coming in from the West Coast, for instance, where they have been used to help move demonstrators,
yes.
and there are lawsuits as a result, and people say I'm being permanently injured and whatnot. How do you respond to that?
Well, it's interesting because it's been on the street since 1982, and we haven't had any complaints like that in the field from normal use, if you would say, street use. We haven't had that kind of problem. The first time it was implemented with the demonstrators in the very situation in California, then those things started to happen. Mm-hmm. So I'm a little bit skeptical on when there are the claims of the injuries, because we haven't had that in years before.
All right, we've got John from your police department back in Thornton here to help us do a little demonstration. Yeah. Give me a scenario in which you might use a nunchuck.
Well, typically, if I want to arrest this individual here, and I say, sir, please put your hands behind your back and turn around, I'm going to put the handcuffs on, he might fold his arms up and passively resist, okay?
Okay.
He's just not going to go along with the program.
Right.
Now, I might start in here with my hands to try to break this free.
Come
on,
buddy.
But you can see how that thing's going to get out of hand.
Uh-huh.
So my idea was to take the OPN here as a lever tool, some way to get these arms out without getting into a major confrontation here.
Sure.
So I'm just going to come in here quickly, mm-hmm. set it through, break it on down here and get control.
Yeah.
From here, I can go right in behind the back.
But John is sitting there. He's sort of passive resistance. Once you start with that, he's not going to passively resist anymore.
Sure. If he takes the arms out, he's going to help me.
Right.
Okay. So I'm going to get started in here to do the technique.
And he says, hey, buddy.
Comes out here. Get in here and get control here.
Yeah. That looks like it works pretty well, John. Does it work pretty well?
Yes,
sir. Give me one more scenario about how this thing works.
Well, typically, the demonstrator situation we were talking about.
Uh-huh.
Someone's down, and they're locked up, folded up. And this is a technique that we've used quite a bit in the field for that purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Again, trying to come in here to get control of the limb, get this person up, because he's not cooperative.
Right.
Again, we'll come in through here, get control, the arm down to here.
Yeah.
Control here, lock it up, and then it's a matter of just torquing here.
You're going to do pretty much whatever that you... Okay, put this thing on me and let me see what this feels like.
Because
you can't see just from the demonstration that what it feels like.
Again, what I'm trying to accomplish here is a total control of the arm here.
Right.
Wrapping the tool up here, locking it on.
Right.
There's no way you can take your arm out of there.
You're right.
Right here.
So yeah. I get it now.
Right in here.
I understand completely.
Okay.
Sergeant, thanks very much. John, appreciate it. It's 22 minutes after the hour. We'll be back.
Police on the streets may soon have something better than a nightstick to help keep order. And while the weapon may be new to law enforcement, it is no stranger to people familiar with the martial arts. Dan Blackburn reports from California.
This may become the modern nightstick for today's police officers. These two pieces of polycarbon plastic attached to a double nylon cord are called nunchakus. Originally, they were developed as a weapon by farmers on the Japanese island of Okinawa. Sensei Fumio Demura is an expert on their use.
But if you training right way for twisting, stuff like that, they'd be, I think, work for the police department.
Today, 25 police departments use them, and more are lining up, turning in their batons for a pair of plastic sticks.
The advantage that the OPN has over the side-handle baton and the straight stick is the fact that it's flexible. Gives the officer the capabilities of using an arrest and control method versus impact.
Essentially, nunchakus, called OPNs after their manufacturer's initials, are used to grab a wrist or ankle and apply pressure and leverage to control a suspect. Officers testified to the nunchakus' effectiveness in removing belligerent drunken drivers from their cars, as shown in this simulation.
The nice thing about it is it prevented myself and other officers from getting injured.
Supporters of these new police tools stress both their effectiveness and relative safety.
In the 7 years since nunchakos were introduced to police officers, only one excessive force lawsuit has been filed. That involved a professional weightlifter and was settled out of court.
Police officers take a 16-hour basic training course on the use of the sticks and say they are particularly useful for women officers since they require little upper body strength. Indeed, this ancient article of Japanese technology seems well on its way to being another modern American import. Dan Blackburn for CNN, Costa Mesa, California.
Some have already done it, okay, but I just want to make sure we get it right. Index finger comes out over, faces you, and your index fingers.
That's it?
Just like a knife. Work it on in, real quick. Pull it on through. You see how you get that in there? Make sure your grip is behind this way, the way you want it. And we just start working here. Now, once you get to here, anyone imagine what this is? Invert. Here, now I want to turn it. Okay, come on up. Yes,
Beginning next month, San Diego police will be carrying a controversial device as standard equipment. They are called nunchucks. Some San Diego officers have already used them in the past, but soon all officers will have them at their disposal. Tim Carr has more for us now in this report.
Officer Pamela Smith has used nunchucks in the past. She and several other officers from San Diego and other law enforcement departments have been training for the past 3 days to learn more about the devices. Officer Smith says the OPNs, or Oracut Police Nunchuckers, are much better than the standard batons.
If I can confront the person with the OPNs and be able to gain control right offhand with the OPNs, then I avoid any confrontation and I avoid any injury to that person or to myself. You have some discomfort with these, but you're not going to have any long-term damage at all. Just enough to get compliance. Once you have compliance and you get the person handcuffed, if that's what's necessary, then you've resolved your situation and you're under control.
Ready? One.
David Dye is one of the instructors. He says the nunchucks are not as harmful as some say.
Since these are flexible, it gives you the capability of wrapping a wrist or wrapping an ankle, controlling that limb. And what happens, in my opinion, when people get hurt, they resist. And when they resist, they're going against their own joints or their own nerve system, and they're really hurting themselves.
In fact, according to police studies, 1 of 5 cases never goes beyond the officer taking the nunchucks from its holder.
These people will go back to their various departments as instructors, and eventually every San Diego police officer will have a set of these as standard equipment. Tim Carr, KNSD News, San Diego.
Well, the officers will have one more day of training, and after that, nunchucks could become as common as the nightstick.
It's part of the martial arts, and it's called a nunchuck. News 8's Jody Hammond reports it has become standard equipment on this police force.
San Diego officers have been trying out the modified nunchuck developed by Oracut since November. It's being used by 40 police departments around the country, but San Diego will now be the largest.
San Diego officers who've worked with the nunchucks say they feel safer having it as part of their equipment. And given the choice, they'd rather carry a nunchuck than a baton.
With a baton, and they're coming at you and attacking you, your only option you have is to hit them with it. With the OPN, we can grab them and take them down and handcuff them without there actually being any impact.
Jody Hammond, News 8.